welcome to Channel 48. My name is Puck. I'm here after the S3, the S4, the S5, and even the Gyro. I'm now here with the Galaxy Advance, the 9070. And I'm gonna flash the iPhone X ROM to this phone. And the base that is used is Android 6. And this is the best ever created Android 6, created by APREX. His name is APREX. He made the ROM, but he has nothing to do with the iOS theming. That is what I did, in fact, but I used the ROM. In fact, a very old ROM. It was created long time ago by APREX. Well, long time, a while ago, but he was the only one that created a ROM that had a working cam and, you know, that was kind of working good. Okay, there's something that you must know about this phone. You will also need an external SD card, and if you're not gonna use that, then you will also find out that in some way the space of your drive is being used in a different way. Okay, so some people were asking me, can I copy apps from the SD card, the internal SD card, to the external SD card? Well, with some apps it could be possible, but you will find out that the external SD card is also being used in some way. I'm not even sure if I have a SD card in here. Let's just take a quick look. Yes, I have a SD card in here. You see that? Here is the SD card. So it kind of, yeah, you will need the external SD card if you want to do this on the Advance, I think. I have another one here. This is another Advance. Let me see. You see, this one also has a card. But one of them has a problem reading the card. At least that was the case a while ago. So what we're installing now, peeps, is... yeah, it's going off a little bit. But... Oh gosh, I don't know what happened. It turned off. This is not good, huh? Okay, so now the phone is officially bricked. As you can see, it will hang in this screen and nothing's gonna happen. So in this video, you're also gonna learn how to fix a bricked Galaxy Advance 9070. Remove the battery, turn it off, hold the volume, home and the power, volume up, home, and then press power, let go whenever you see the logo, and the device should go into a recovery mode. In twerp, we're gonna go to wipe, and we're gonna do advanced wipe, and we're gonna do the whole thing again. We're gonna wipe the machine. Okay, we're gonna clean it up, remove all traces of the previous failed install, and then I'm gonna enable MTP, yeah, in mount, under mount, I'm gonna enable MTP, and then my computer will see the phone and I will be able to copy files to the internal drive of this phone. So that's what I'm gonna do, because this is gonna fail again. Okay, so this is no need to try to install it again, because this has nothing to do with a not cleaned drive or wiped Dalvik or all these things. It has nothing to do with this. This really has to do with the file being on the external drive and trying to be installed on the phone. So, okay, let's make a long story short. We're gonna cut the video right here. I'm not gonna show you any failure anymore, any brick anymore. What I'm gonna do, I'm gonna go and copy the file to the internal. As I said, I'm gonna enable MTP, mount MTP, and if MTP is mounted, then I will be easily able to copy the firmware from my computer to the internal drive of the phone. Let's go to that point. Okay guys, this is what I'm talking about. Here you can see that we also have enable MTP. This is what I was saying. When you're gonna enable it, then suddenly you can see the drives of your phone. If you're gonna disable it, they are gone. So now you cannot copy anything to the phone. So you must enable MTP. Oops, enable it. You see? And then you can copy the file, the PUC-ROM, the ROM. You copy it to the internal of the device, Okay, and then you do the installation. So that's how to do it. Okay, what I'm gonna do, I don't wanna save any settings, so I'm just gonna remove the battery and just reboot the device again. So that's how to do it, okay? So let's continue with the installing. Okay, I'm gonna show you that I also have it on, you see? We were trying to install this one and it's saying, error, file not good, blah, blah, blah. But this file is good. There's nothing wrong with the file. We copied the file now to the internal drive of this device. Yeah? And now, you see it here? iPhone X, Android 6, Janice. So, let's go ahead and do the install real fast. So we do a wipe, advanced, Dalvik system, catch, data. Let's just do that. Let's just go for that. Okay, and now we're gonna go back and we're gonna hit the little home and say install. But now we're gonna install the same file, but now from the internal drive. Let's see what's gonna happen. If it's gonna fail again, if you're gonna get an error again, if it will go wrong. But I can guarantee you that now the installation will go just fine. It will take a second though. You must remember that. Installing of the system takes a second. Also on the S3 Mini, it also takes a second. This battery, we fixed it in a video, but then I failed using the phone on daily base and in fact the cells drained again and I will have to do a fix again with this fantastic device. We can do that while the phone is busy. This is the battery of the S3 Mini. I have a beautiful iPhone X ROM as well for the S3 Mini based on Android 7.12. Of course, with thanks to nobody else than McClaw for that. I'm gonna make sure that the first and the last one should connect. I think this should be it. This. Okay, I see that we're done or not. Yes, you see, the file is installed. And now, only thing we have to do is reboot, because this is a ROM. This is not a mod. So let's reboot the system. I think we have a red boot screen for this phone. I think, if I can remember it well. There you go. And this is the Christmas version of the iPhone X, iPhone 10 boot screen. This is the Christmas version. There we go. So I don't have to hold it in my hand. Meanwhile, gonna continue with this. See, this light must also go on, huh? This is it. Don't be shy, just do it. Come on. And the red light should go on here. There you go, baby. You see that? And now you must leave it at the place where it's gonna charge. You see? Now it's charging the red light. Oh, you don't see anything, man. This bloody camera. Okay, now you can see that it's charging. And we're booting the Advance. And this is how it should become. Hello. Battery is a little low. This is what we're gonna get on the Advance. So this is a beautiful, beautiful concept again. Well, concept, it's themed. And all credits, of course, to all the app makers that did their best to make it beautiful, as beautiful as possible. Don't forget, even though it's all beautiful, most of these apps, they are apps that are being, given to us to use for free, but in fact we can also buy these apps, okay? And whenever we're gonna buy these apps, the experience is gonna get better. But until now, I could not make a decision of what to buy yet, you see? So I think we're coming to a point now, thanks to fantastic apps that are in our collection and are being offered. We're coming to a point that we're gonna make a choice of which apps we're gonna keep using in the future. But then we also have to make a deal with the guy that works on the app, that creates the app. So there is much more work for me to do to really make a choice which apps we're gonna 100% adopt in the system. And then probably one day there's gonna be some little price list of the apps that we completely want banner free in our position, because at this point they are free, but yeah, the guy must also make a buck, so he inserts banners. But then again, I'm not really a fan of that on my phone, so yeah, we have tools to kind of stop that, so yeah, until the time that we're stopping it and that we're gonna buy these apps, we're gonna continue, of course, stopping it coming our way. And we have a fantastic tool for that, and that is of course our firewall, our root firewall. So you must be rooted, but the system is rooted. Whenever you install this ROM and everything went right, then you are rooted, okay? So you will then have the possibility, even though you're small and this is old phone, you will be able to enable the firewall. You see that? And that has something to do with the root up here. We must also turn on the root, because you can see about the phone, this is Android 6.01, so you will always have to enable the root, okay? Because APREX also turned off root in developers options. At least that was just the way it was. You see, root access disabled. And now we have root access for apps only. You see that? All right, so the system is installed. As you can see, the ROM works just fine. We're gonna just give a little skip there, skip anyway. I'm not gonna show you the complete setup because I must get ready. I have to DJ tonight and I don't have too much time, but I wanted to finish this video, even though it's only about the Galaxy Advance. But this is a beautiful phone, really. There's nothing wrong with this phone. And whoever has this phone should be using this phone, okay? We have here a pop-up that tells us that we must enable the permission notification access, okay? And boom, there you go, my friends. Remember that I told you about the three empty icons? You just take them, you just take them and put them into a folder like this. You see that? So you get a folder, and then this folder you can hide it. It's very responsive, the screen. It's really, it feels really good. It feels even more responsive than on the S5 and the S4 on this phone. I don't know what it is. This really, it was as if this team, this launcher, the guy that made it, I think he understood that whatever I said one day, that every good launcher cancel. What happened here? That every good launcher deserves a ROM. And this is again the case, as you can see, because this is the best iPhone X mod for Android phones that is that I could, you know, there is nothing better that I can find than the one that I modded. So yeah, it's good one time to also create something and you feel that, hey, this is the best that is around. You can make the icons bigger, change wallpaper. You have a set of wallpapers there that comes with the launcher. So yeah, peeps, I can say that 1 year later, after we started with this project, it was 1 year ago, we improved. We improved from small rookie to, you know, to big rookie. And look what we are doing now, 1 year later. So we'll see where we're gonna be next year, but I'm happy to announce Android 6.01 iPhone X mod. ROM for the Samsung Galaxy Advance. Oh yeah, of course the cam works. How you mean cam's not working? Where did you get that idea? Make a picture, my friend. Ding. See pictures made. Make a video for me. Testing 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I really love your wife.
Testing 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7.
No, that was not it. That was not our video. I don't know. Where is our video? Oh, here it is.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I really love your wife.
Oh yeah, because your wife is a very nice woman. She can cook very good food. So respect to your wife. Okay, don't get me wrong there, peeps. So there you go. This is it. You can make the icon smaller, bigger, but I'm not going to talk about it. Here you have your iNoti. I'm not going to tell you that you must go into the firewall and then enable root access. It's going to ask for root. Oh no, we must first go into the developers option, hey, to the developers options, and then enable the root. This cable is, I don't know what is wrong with this one. Don't touch it. So, and then, you must, of course, go through all the apps that I showed in my previous videos. If you're not gonna do that, your experience will be totally not what I want you to have. But again, that. It's just that's just the way it is. These beautiful, not all of these beautiful apps are completely 100% free. Some of them, the guys are, you know, adding some advertisements to them. The most important ones have no ads to say it this way. That is the firewall, of course. We have an internal virus scanner, Bitdefender, but you must connect to the internet first before you can do a scan. But trust me, before even going onto the internet, make sure that you enabled the developers options. Go into the developers options, okay? Turn on your root access. It's really important because this is a very old phone, to say it this way, even though it looks like new and gold. It's an old phone and it deals differently with certain things. So you must give it a chance. You must be nice to it. Okay, you must kind of excuse it to do certain things. Here, enable firewall, boom, root access, and then go through the list. Really, go through the list. And all these things, all these standalone apps that don't need the internet to be happy and to run, you can block them all, including your camera, okay? Including your gallery. So 1040, the 10,040 cannot be accessed to go into your gallery. You know, there are many things that you will learn if you're gonna study this root firewall, okay? I'm not gonna talk about it too long. Don't forget to put the whitelist to blacklist so it will block whatever you're gonna select. Otherwise it won't work. And don't forget to say apply rules. But it will ask you yourself, would you like to apply the rules whenever you're gonna quit the software? These things you must do. Another thing that you must do with this phone, if you're gonna install this, Because if you don't do it, you're a thief of your own privacy and data. Is go to privacy, and then go to privacy guard. Say, okay, here, you turn that on by default, and here you go to advanced, okay? Because you will be able to do that with this ROM. It's very powerful ROM. And then I want you to go and look through all these apps that are connected to the internet. This one will be blocked. We'll have no internet access. You will only use the dialer locally. So this one will also be blocked. So you don't have to worry about this. You know, the Android keyboard, what is it doing? Read contacts and start at boot. This is the internal, yeah, the internal keyboard of your device. You see, you can tweak it the way you want. Okay, this goes for all the other systems that are also on Lineage OS. Okay, very important as well is even kijken, is the app stores. Okay, you must go through the app stores. You will see that the firewall is a very friendly one. Start at boot notification toast and root access. It's not doing anything more. You see, that's way to go. But the TabX Home, the launcher, as you can see, vibrate, camera, notification. That's because you can also, you know, here. This also belongs to the launcher. Wait, let me show you. This also belongs to the launcher. So that's why it wants to use the camera, the flashlight, etc. These things. But it can use them freely because in the firewall, it won't have no access to the internet. So whatever it's enabling, it's not a problem. It can be enabled all. In fact, it won't hurt me because the system cannot go on the internet. So this, it will only be doing for me and not for nobody else. You see, that's the difference. Okay, so here we made the Galaxy Advance a fantastic, beautiful phone again. I think you're gonna love it. I think, yeah, it's beautiful, still a nice phone. Samsung Galaxy Advance, gold plated, painted, I mean. And that is it. I want to thank you for watching. I'm sure you, if you have the Galaxy Advance, you're gonna love your Galaxy Advance 100 times more than what it was on Jelly Bean, I think. Very useful, useless software for 2017. But now you are kind of updated, and if you don't gonna do banking and you're not gonna do crazy things with this phone, you can use it as your daily driver. Let me know if it crashes on you, if you get problems. I want to give thanks to APREX for this beautiful for the work on this ROM. Here you can see it, Janice and Kernel by APREX at MaxiCM Team number 1. So MaxiCM Team, APREX, and all you guys that worked on CyanogenMod mod on this, what you see in my hands here running on the Galaxy Advance, thank you so much. God bless you, we love you, and yeah, I hope to show many more future projects of you guys. Thanks again for watching, people. If you liked this video, don't forget to leave it a like and to subscribe to my channel if you did not already. Hit the little notifying bell so you will be updated whenever I upload one of my videos again. And that's it. Until then, and stay well.